Aloha, my name is Jamie with Leis by Jay, and today we're going to be making an all-green tea lepo in the Haku style. Just wanted to say thank you so much for supporting Kamehameha Schools Maui Ho'olaule'a 2022, as well as Papa'eha Class of 2030. If you went ahead and purchased a Haku kit, it's going to come in one of these gallon ziplock bags. In that bag, you will have pre-cut and ready-to-go long pieces of tea leaf that you'll be using for the base, pre-cut pieces of tea leaf here that you will be using as filler, and two pieces of twine that you can use at the end to combine them to tie them on your head. Let's get started.
Materials included in your kit will be pre-cut base long pieces of tea leaf, as well as pre-cut filler pieces of tea leaf, two pieces of twine. You will also need a flat surface to work on, and a pair of scissors. You're going to take three pieces of your base tea leaf. I'm going to go ahead and twist them to make it easier to tie into a single knot. These leaves have been previously frozen and thawed for the day, so that it'll make it easier to work with. Make sure your knot is nice and tight before you start, separating your pieces into three sections. And you're going to create about three pieces of braid before you start, just so you'll have something to connect to your twine when you're done. You're going to do just a regular braid with left piece over the center and then right piece over the center. And then at any time, you can start adding in your fillers. Right now I'm using two pieces of pre-cut leaves in each section before braiding over the middle and flipping the leaves over. You can also use a single leaf if you wanted it thinner, or up to 3 to 4 leaves to make it for a very full haku. You're going to continue to add on additional filler leaves, braiding over each time. You're adding on a filler and twisting them up. And then we're going to get to another point where you can see it better. Again, this is just adding on two pieces of leaves, pinching them in the center to fold them in half, adding them on top of each other, folding the outside piece of braid over, so now it becomes the center, and twisting the other half of the filler over. Just keep repeating that same process, putting on two leaves, folding and pinching it in half, folding over your outside braid from the other end, folding the leaves over. Again, you're pinching it close, putting it together, flipping the outside leaf, folding it to the center, flipping your leaves over. Continue to do this process until you come to the point where you are going to need to add in additional base leaves so that you can continue to make them longer. Okay, we're going to go ahead and take another long base leaf, and then we try to get the pointed end shiny side up, placing it downwards onto the center short leaf of the base. That short piece will be behind your new leaf. You're going to take your same two pieces of filler leaf, pinching them in the middle, holding them tightly with your other hand, taking the outside leaf, don't get it confused with what's underneath the new leaf, folding it over, and then flipping your filler leaves as you go. This part may take a little bit more time. You want to be careful what you're doing, paying attention to what's being added and what is being flipped over. Your center leaves add-on should always be in the middle, and flipping it over will secure it. Keep in mind, every time you flip over or add on a filler or even a new leaf, it should always be kept tight. Again, this is adding on a new leaf, always in the center. Adding on your fillers. And then taking the outside leaf to braid it over, flipping only your filler leaves. Then you have your extension and leaf piece to start with. We're going to continue to add on your filler leaves. Again, just a reminder, keep everything in your hand as tight as you can. Adding on new leaf whenever your centers get short. And then we go. This is the back of what the haku should look like, of your braided style. Now that we're finished and we have the desired length, you want to take all three pieces and do about 3 to 4 braids, just like we did in the beginning, so that you'll have something to attach your twine to tie it together. So you'll see here I'm already on the 3rd or 4th braid, making it super tight so none of your fillers come out. And just like the beginning, we're going to twist it and create a single knot to tie everything together and lock it in. Making sure to pull your knot tight, leaving just a little piece of the braid left in there so that you have something to connect it to. Now you're going to take your scissors and cut the excess piece off. Take your 2 pieces of twine, one on each side, underneath the knot, and we're just gonna make a double knot to tie it tightly and secure. Flipping it over, doing the exact same thing on the other end where you started. Again, it's just a simple double knot, making sure you don't catch any of the leaves that will be laying flat down. Pick them up and tie it underneath it. And that should be it. Go ahead and flip your haku upside down, cut off any of the loose ends that you may have from when you're adding on your long piece of faces, or anything that just looks like it's out of place. Please be careful not to cut the actual haku itself, just all the little pieces that have been striving out. Mm-hmm. And you can go ahead and flip it over and start spreading out your leaves, making them thicker. Or you could keep it the way that it was. It's just your preference how you want it to look. I kind of like to open mine up. And here's the final product. Now we have a Lei Po'o Haku style. It can be worn on your head, over a papale, or even without a papale. It's okay for it to overlap on each other as you're tying it closed. You have a beautiful Lei Po'o. Mahalo everyone, thank you for supporting. Ta ta ikena o hi ilo ru papa lohi mai a o mau.